This video is just a short extract from the entire course. If you wish to see all of the videos from this series at higher quality and in far larger screen size, head over to ifskills.com.
In this lesson, we'll be discussing the display modes of the Rhino viewports and more manipulation techniques. In order to do so, I'm going to start off by building a 3D object. If we go to the solid menu and select cone, it prompts us for the base of a cone. Go ahead and click in the top viewport. Now we're prompted for the radius. Drag the mouse out, click again, and the end of the cone. Come into the front viewport and click one last time. Now we have a three-dimensional cone. All viewports are currently set to the wireframe mode. As you can see, you can't really tell what this object looks like. You can just see the wireframe of the model. In order to get a better view of what this object looks like, we need to shade it in. To do that, right-click on the name of the view that you would like to shade, and you can see we're currently in the wireframe mode, and you can select Shaded Mode. Now this view is shaded in. If you'd like to shade in the other modes, just go ahead and left-click anywhere in the view, but not on an object, to make the viewport active, and then you can click the right mouse button to repeat the last command, which is the shaded. I'm going to continue doing this to the other views. Left-click and right-click. The right-click, the Enter key, and the spacebar are all essentially the same key and have the function of repeating the last command. Another manipulation technique of the viewports is to maximize a viewport. This can be done by right-clicking and choosing Maximize, or just by double-clicking on the name of the viewport. To minimize a viewport, go ahead and double-click it again, and you can see we go back to our four views. If you're using the viewports and you get them rotated, something's upside down, and you pan one, and you've sort of lost your orientation, and you need to get them back so that you know which way is which, go ahead and click on this icon right here for viewports, and you'll see it resets all four views back to their original position. When you have multiple objects, let's say a cone and a sphere, so go ahead and build a sphere on their solid, sphere. We're going to choose center radius. I'm going to go ahead and click, drag out, build a sphere, and make sure if these objects are not intersecting as mine are, make them intersect. You can drag one into the other by clicking on the object, and it will highlight, and hold down the mouse button and just move it and drag it so that these are intersecting inside of one another. I'm going to go ahead and maximize the perspective viewport. Now, another working shaded mode that might become useful in situations like this, in order to see how exactly the objects are intersecting one another, is the ghosted mode. So if we right-click on the perspective, we can choose ghosted, and now we can see the models with transparency. So we can see the inside of the other model, which reveals where the sphere exactly is. These are the two most common modes for working in Rhino, shaded and ghosted. I'm going to go ahead and minimize this view. One of the other means of manipulating the views, if you put your cursor over top of the border between two views, you can drag the view left or right, changing the size of them. You can also get the borders above and below, dragging and scaling them that way. You can reset the viewports by clicking on this icon right here, for viewports. You can also pull the viewports out of their region by clicking and holding on the viewport name and dragging. You can see that now this viewport can be independently adjusted of the other viewports. Click and drag. I'm going to go ahead and reset these viewports by clicking on the four views. That concludes this lesson.